In this video, we're going to answer the question, what are the different classes of steel conduit? This question relates to the video that I made on the Conlock cleanroom range of conduit and fittings from MetPro, where we took a dive into the pernicious problem of zinc whiskers. So please go and check that video out after watching this one. Classes of conduit can be found in the BSEN 61386 series of British standards, which replaced earlier standards. There is also table 5.1 in the IET guidance note 1, which you may find useful and we'll have a look at a little bit later in the video. The classification relates to a few different qualities of the conduit, the main ones being compression and temperature ranges, but we're going to look at the quality that visually sets it apart, which is the surface corrosion protection. The classes of conduit in this context are Class 1 Light, which consists of low protection both inside and out, for example, using something like priming paint. Class 2 is medium, which consists of medium protection inside and out. For example, in this case, we might use stoved enamel or air drying paint or electroplating. Class 3 is medium heavy, and this is an interesting one because it's a combination of classes 2 and 4. So stoved enamel or electroplating offering medium protection on the inside of the conduit, and perhaps something like sherrodized offering high protection on the outside. Class 4 is then heavy protection, which consists of high protection both inside and out, for example by the use of hot dipped zinc coating or maybe sherrodizing again. Now, if you're wondering what that word sherrodizing means, it's one method of galvanizing or adding zinc to the surface layer of the material, in this case conduit. Sherrodizing is the hardest and most wear resisting method of galvanizing, making it perfect for heavy duty protection. So interestingly, there's only really three classes of protection, but two of them are combined to give a fourth. It's pretty rare to come across class one conduit in installation work, and then perhaps the slightly longer in the tooth electricians among us will remember installing black enamel conduit and accessories, which would conform for class two conduit. We probably also remember painting the scratches and marks caused by the hand tools on the tube during installation, and that awful gut-wrenching moment when you'd bend a piece and one dodgy patch of paint would peel away like the skin of an orange. Of course, we'd use this type of conduit in areas that are dry and non-corrosive, and then in areas where there's a chance of damp or corrosion, then class 3 or class 4 conduit would be considered. In addition to these requirements, there are various tests that the different classes of conduit need to go through to meet the British standard. For example, these tests would include the durability of the markings on the conduit, a test of the mechanical properties of the conduit, resistance to corrosion, and of course, electrical continuity. There's also information available in table 5.1 in the IET's guidance note 1, which you may find useful when you're selecting the class of conduit for a particular project. The table lists the relevant ranges of impact that the conduits are tested to, as well as temperature range, IP rating, corrosion protection, tensile strength, and suspended load. In addition to this, there are other installations that may require the use of specialised finishes on conduit and accessories, such as clean rooms like laboratories and data centres. In environments like this, there is a possibility that traditional galvanised finishes containing zinc can actually start to produce tiny contaminants that, if they get into sensitive equipment or materials being produced, can cause them to fail catastrophically. These are the zinc whiskers that we mentioned earlier, and they can be seriously damaging. One solution is the Conlock cleanroom system from MetPro, which has a surface treatment that helps to eliminate the source of these zinc whiskers. Now, we've created a whole video on this subject, so check that out, and there's also more information on the manufacturer's website. One thing that I found really interesting about this range is that each length of Conlock steel conduit for cleanrooms is supplied with one threaded end so that it can be connected to traditional conduit systems as well as Conlock accessories, so that might be useful if you're looking to add to an existing installation. And if you'd like to see the Conlock system in action, please check out this video here. Thank you very much for watching.